In this video, we're going to learn about the measurement tool, which is found here on your left-hand toolbar. And I'll go ahead and click on the tool to turn it on. And notice when I click on measure that my mouse becomes a crosshair. And if I click and drag, it will measure from the point that I clicked to wherever I dragged to. And when I let go, it stops measuring, and I still have that ruler attached to my mouse. So if I click in the lower left corner of this box and I drag, I can quickly measure the diagonal of the box or the width of the box or the height of the box. And when I'm done, I simply let go. And now when you're done using the measurement tool, you want to go back to using your rectangle selection tool or some other tool, but there is a convenient flyout for the rectangle selection tool that you can click on to let go of the ruler. Notice that as soon as I turn on measure, the rectangle selection flyout appears. Another thing that can be helpful for measuring and giving you a sense of size when you're looking at your screen is the grid. And that is found, of course, under your view toolbar, your view drop-down menu, grid, show. And this will turn on our grid. Perhaps what I could even do is just zoom in more closely. So I'll zoom in on a small area of our design so that you can see, and perhaps the fabric in this case not displaying the fabric, so leaving the category as smooth but just making the fabric color to none, that'll really allow you to see what you're sort of working on in technical terms and not have the texture of the fabric to what the point is. If I know that my grid is based upon metric, and every large red line is a centimeter, and every small gray line is a millimeter, then you can quickly kind of get a visualization. Even at 578% zoomed in, I can quickly tell that these are just over 10 millimeter tall letters in their lowercase, and I know that the width of this is probably 2 or 3 millimeters based upon the fact that every square is a millimeter. So this is a way that your grid can be helpful with keeping sort of size. And then if you want to know a specific measurement, you click on the measure tool and you click and drag to measure the height or the column width. See, I can see that in the widest area, the column will be 2.1. In the thinner areas, the column will be 1.1. Also about measurements, I should point out that if you look under your tools drop-down menu for options, on the general tab, there is the opportunity to change your unit of measurement from metric to imperial. And if I clicked on to imperial, then it would tell me, I'll just click on it, see. So now it's switched to imperial or back to metric, but it will not make those changes until the next time you start the software. So if you want to switch your grid and everything from, then these red lines would become inches. And the minor grid lines would become tenths of inches. So those are your choices, and that is how to use your measurement toolbar.